The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, third chapter, text number 18 through 30, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 30th, 1968, in Los Angeles.
All glory to the assembled devotees. Who is reading? Go on. What part? Yes. 98. Oh, yes. Yes. Go on. All right. Go on,
Lily. 18. A self-realized man has no purpose to fulfill his discharge of his prescribed duties, nor has he any reason not to perform such work, nor has he any need to depend on any other living being.
This is very important. What is actually self-realization? All processes, religious process, yoga practice, philosophical speculation, or anything for self-realization, any method. What is the purpose and what is the ultimate goal of the self-realization? That ultimate goal is to understand that I am eternal servant of God, Krishna. That's all. This is self-realization. So long one is identifying oneself with this material world, with this body, with this mind, it is not self-realization. Self-realization means that I am spirit and the Supreme Lord is also spirit. So I am part and parcel of the Supreme. Just like, take for example this finger. The finger is the part and parcel of this body. So when the finger can understand that I am part and parcel of this whole body, and my duty is to serve the whole body, that is self-realization. So long one is not understanding this point, he is illusion. What is the position of this finger? Suppose this finger is a person. Any individual spirit is a person. That we have discussed in the second chapter. Everyone of us, individual person. So, as individual person, what is my position? My position is just like you are individual citizen of the state. What is your position? To serve the state. That is your position. That is good citizenship. What does it mean, a good citizen? One who is trying to serve the state. Take for example in Russia and China. They have made the state as worshipable. Any component part of the state citizen is to sacrifice everything for the state. In your country also, the death sword is calling, come on, you have to go to the fight. But you cannot say no, because you are component part of the state. If you deny, then you are not a good citizen. You'll be arrested, you'll be harassed by the government. Similarly, we are component parts of the whole Supreme Whole. This is self-realization. It is very simple thing. Self-realization does not mean anything very extraordinary. Hitya unnatha rupam sarupena avasthiti. Mukti. This is called mukti, means liberation or self-realization. What is that? Hitya unnatha rupam. Giving up a different identity. In the conditioned state, we are identifying, I am American. I am Indian. I am human being. I am this, I am that, I am white, I am black. These are all designations. Actually, this is not self-realization. Self-realization is that I am neither American, nor Indian, nor black, nor white, nor anything. I am spirit, soul, part and parcel of the whole, Krishna. This is self-realization. So long it is not completely realized, so long we have got doubt, we have to make progress. And as soon as we come to the point and firmly convinced, that is self-realization. Therefore, here it is stated, a self-realized man has no purpose to fulfill in the discharge of his prescribed duties. Prescribed duties either take forth any scripture, take your Bible, take Quran, take Vedas, there are some prescribed duties. Just like in your Bible, there are 10 commandments. Thou shalt not kill. So, for whom? One who is not self-realized. One who is self-realized that I am part and parcel of the Supreme God. Everyone is part and parcel of the Supreme God. And human being, animals, ant, aquatic, beast, bird, every living entity is part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. That is self-realization. Then how can you kill? If everyone is part and parcel, son of the Supreme, how can kill your brother? This is self-realization. You will hesitate even to kill even an ant, just like we published that picture in our Back to Godhead. The hunter was taking pleasure in killing animals half dead. And when he was self-realized, he was hesitating to kill even an ant. Why? Self-realized. So he has no prescribed duty. To him you have got to say, thou shalt not kill. It is automatically not kill. Because he is self-realized. Self-realized person does not do any harm to anyone because he knows everyone in relationship with the Supreme. The central point is Krishna. Neither he misuses anything. He makes everything proper use. This nice foodstuff, it is given by Krishna, let it be offered to Krishna. That is not misuse. That is the proper use. Here is a nice rose flower. It is manufactured by Krishna's energy. Let it be offered to Krishna. This is self-realization. So, one who has got this Krishna consciousness, he is self-realized. Everything, stop telling is Krishna. So, what he has got to follow any other prescribed? Everything is complete there. Aradhita Jadi Hari Stavasata Tatke. If one has realized the Supreme Lord, then he has no more any duty for undergoing austerities, penance, this or that, all prescribed rules. His business is finished. When a man is cured, there is no more requisition of medicine. He is in healthier state. So we engage in devotional service, in Krishna consciousness, means he is in healthier state. He has no more any prescribed. So, not has any reason not to perform such work. Another thing. One should not think because I am in Krishna consciousness, therefore, I shall not rise early in the morning. This is prescribed duty for one week. No. You have to do that. Lopa Sangra. He practically has no duty but to show example to the general mass of people. He has got so many duties. Even Krishna. Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. He was also going to school to study. He accepted a spiritual master. He was offering respect to his elderly brother in relationship. So, he does not, a self-realized person, he is always engaged in Krishna consciousness, but he does not deviate with the prescribed duties all. Because others will follow, or others will say, I am also self-realized. Therefore one has to do. Nor has he any need to depend on any other living being. He is free. Because he knows that I am part and parcel of Krishna, so I am dependent on Krishna. Krishna is providing millions and trillions of living entities. Why not me? I am directly engaged in Krishna's service. This is the position of self-realization. Narayana parasadvi nartitasthana bhimkati. So on.
Therefore, without being attached to the fruits of activity, one should act as a matter of duty. For by working without attachment, one is aiming to succeed.
Yes.
Therefore, this discipline is the personality of God to the devotee and liberation to the impersonal.
What is that supreme? The conception of supreme, for the impersonalist, the impersonal Brahma effulgence is the supreme. Just like light. When you come to the sunshine, that is light. But the devotee, they are not satisfied with the sunshine. They want to penetrate into the sun planet and see the sun god. That is devotee's position. And one who cannot do so, he is satisfied with the sun sign. Everything is light. Sun sign is light. Sun glow is light. And if you enter into sun glow, there is also light. So, these are all spiritual positions. Impersonalist or personalist. But the impersonalist goal is partial, because they are satisfied simply by seeing the light. And the devotees, they are not satisfied simply by seeing the light. They want to enter within the light to see where from the light is coming. That is the difference between impersonalist and personalist. They are farther advanced. So, Chidananda Vigraha, the Lord is full bliss, eternal knowledge. So, impersonal is well satisfied with only knowledge, jnana, light, that's all. Knowledge is light. But further advanced, say the yogis, they want to see the localized, just like the sun globe. And the devotees, they want to see the person who is predominating over the sun globe. This is a crude example. So, the goal, ultimate goal, it is described, the Supreme is the personality of Godhead for the devotee. And liberation for the impersonal. The impersonal is they simply want to be free from this material atmosphere and go to the spiritual atmosphere. Just like one who is in the darkness of a room, his aspiration is how to see light. That's all. The impersonalist means simply to see light, knowledge. And personalist means to direct, to be in direct touch with the Supreme Personality of God.
Person asking for Krishna or in Krishna consciousness, under proper guidance and without attachment to the result of the will, is certainly making progress towards the supreme goal of life. Indirectly, Arjuna is told that he should fight the battle of Kurukshetra without attachment, in the interest of Krishna, because Krishna wanted him to fight. To be a good man or a non-violent man is also a personal attachment. But to act on behalf of the supreme desire is to act without attachment to the result. That is the perfect action of the highest degree, recommended by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. Vedic rituals, like prescribed sacrifices, are performed by persons for purification of impious activities that will perform in the field of sense gratification. But a person who is acting in Krishna consciousness is transcendental to the actions and reactions of good or evil will. A Krishna conscious person has no attachment to the result, but acts on behalf of Krishna alone. He engages in all kinds of activities, but is completely non-attached.
Yes. That's like you go to your office. You are working on behalf of the particular office. So, your duty is to discharge the occupation which is entrusted upon you. So far the loss or gain of that department or that establishment, you have nothing to do. So, a Krishna conscious person acts on behalf of Krishna. These boys, they are going to preach Krishna consciousness. People may receive it or not receive it. That doesn't matter. Their duty is to preach. The fortunate person will be attracted, unfortunate may not be attracted. But they have to do the duty. It is very simple. So, a Krishna conscious person should not be disturbed whether his preaching work is being accepted by the people or not. It doesn't matter. My Guru Maharaj used to say that if somebody said that we went to preach in such and such place, only there were three or four attendants. So, my Guru Maharaj used to encourage them, and this is a factor. Why? Two, three men were there, that's sufficient. If there were none, you could speak, and the world should see, hear. Why you are disappointed? So, even the world should hear, and then our kirtan is sufficient. You don't mind, because only fortunate person. Bhavanam, janmanam ante, manushanam sahasreshu. So to become God conscious, to Krishna conscious, it's not very cheap thing. He requires a great amount of austerity, penance to come to this stage. So never be disappointed that because people are not responding. There are many good examples. When Lord Jesus Christ also preached God consciousness, only a few followers were there, and still he had to sacrifice his life, but he was never disappointed. That should be the attitude of the preacher. People may accept it or not accept it. We should go on. Because if Krishna is satisfied, if Krishna sees, oh, these boys are doing very nice, they are doing, trying their best to pray, that is your, that's all. People may accept or not accept, it doesn't matter. No.
Even
seeing like Janitor and others attained the professional stage by performing the prescribed duties. Therefore, just for the sake of educating the people in general, you should perform your work. Perform.
There is
no cause of disappointment. You have to do your duty. That's all. Kajam. Kajam means it is my duty. I have to do it.
But the other party was determined to fight. So in such a right cause, there is a necessity for fighting. Therefore, although one who is situated in Krishna consciousness may not have any interest in the world, he still works to teach the people how to live and how to act. Experienced persons in Krishna consciousness can act in such a way that others will follow, and this is explained in the following verse.
Here.
21. Whatever action is performed by a great man, common men will follow in his footsteps. And whatever standards he set by exemplary acts, all the world will see.
This is very important. Therefore, leaders must be very ideal. Then automatically, the country or the society becomes nicely situated. Because if the leader of the society is perfect, therefore, formerly, monarchy was current, and the king was educated very highly how to administer state, just like Maharaj Yudhishthira. Maharaj Yudhishthira, ideal king. Lord Ramchandra, ideal king. Somebody came to Lord Ramchandra and made him responsible that how your kingdom is going, that my son in the presence of his father has died. You see, king was responsible for that. If there is severe cold, the king is responsible for that. If there is severe heat, the king is responsible for that. Just try to understand how much a king was responsible for the happiness of the city. The ideal king, and therefore the citizens also followed. They became Krishna conscious. They became all devotees. And if the leader is a sinful man, and doing all impious activities, then how you can expect the citizen to be all good and pious? It is not possible. So here it is very important subject matter. Whatever action is performed by a great man, common man will follow in his footprints. There was good leader wanted. You haven't got to educate individually every citizen. If you have got a good leader, then the citizens automatically become good. And whatever standard he sets by exemplary act, all the world pursues. One.
O son of speaker, there is no word to describe to me within all the three planetary systems. Neither am I in want of anything, nor have I the need to obtain anything, and yet I am engaged in the work.
Yes, yes, see. Krishna, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We work because we need something. But what need he has? He is full. He is self-sufficient. But still he comes. As it is stated, yada-yada hi dharmasya gnani bhavati bharat. As soon as there is discrepancy in the discharge of religious principle, abhuthanam adharmasya, and there is prominence of irreligiosity. Tadātmānam sijāmaham. At that time I descend. Why Krishna descends? That is explained by Krishna. He comes himself, he sends his representative, he sends his son to reform. Krishna or Krishna's devotee or Krishna's son. Why? Lord Jesus Christ sacrificed his life just to show that a human society must be God-conscious. But unfortunately, people do not take care. They are following, they are calling themselves, they are Christian, but they are not following the example of Lord Jesus Christ. That they should follow. Everyone, a person in Krishna consciousness, they also should follow what Krishna's devotee and Krishna. That is required. So, either Krishna or his representative who come on this planet or in this world just to show example how you should live, how you should utilize your human form of life. They have nothing to gain. They are complete. Those who are coming from spiritual kingdom or kingdom, they have no want. They haven't got to do anything. They are all perfect. But still they do. Similarly, those who want to be leader of the society, they should be ideal persons. This is the Krishna conscious person. Then the whole world will be happy. Otherwise, this nonsense simply by manipulating votes, if they become leaders, what they can do? They have no education. They have no training. How to do good to the people? They cannot do. Only those who are devotees, those who are Krishna conscious, God conscious, they can do actual benefit to the society. Others cannot.
Everything being in full operation in the personality of Godhead and naturally existing in all truth, there is no duty for the Supreme Personality of Godhead to perform. One who wants to see the results of work has some designated duty, but one who has nothing to achieve within the three planetary systems certainly has no duty. And yet Lord Krishna was engaged on the battlefield of Kurukshetra as the leader of the Kshatriyas, because the Kshatriyas are duty-bound give protection to the distressed. Although he has he is above all the regulations of revealed scriptures, he does not do anything which is not directed by the scriptures. 23. For if I did not engage in work, O Father, then all men would follow my path. 24. If I could speak to work, then all these worlds would be put to ruination, and I would be in the form of creating unwanted population and thereby destroy the peace of all sentient beings. 24. Vanasamsara is unwanted population which disturbs the peace of the general society. In order to check this social disturbance, there are prescribed rules and regulations by which the population can automatically become peaceful and organized in spiritual progress in life. When Lord Krishna descends, naturally he deals with such rules and regulations in order to maintain the prestige and necessity of such important performances. The Lord is said to be the father of all living entities, and if the living entities are misguided indirectly, the responsibility goes to the Lord. Therefore, whenever there is a general disregard for such regulative principles, the Lord himself descends and corrects the society. We should, however, note carefully that although we have to follow the footsteps of the Lord, we still have to remember that we cannot imitate him. Following and imitating are not on the same level.
Now, Krishna had the age of 7 years old, he lived at Govardhan. So if we try to imitate, so Krishna lived at the Govardhan Hill, let me also try. That is not for me. You cannot do that, you see. Because sometimes the foolish rascals, they say, oh, Krishna performed Rasleela. Let me also perform Rasleela. Therefore I forbid. They don't discuss Krishna's Rasleela to the ordinary person. They cannot understand. They simply think that it is very nice to dance with girls, boys and girls dancing. No. We have to follow the instruction what is given in the Bhagavad Gita. We cannot imitate him. He is all powerful. Oh. They are the same example. Just like the sun sign. The sun sign can absorb moisture from filthy place, but he is not infected. Sun is not infected. But if you go to a filthy place, you become contaminated immediately. Yes. So nobody should try to imitate the all powerful. But one should try to follow his instruction. That should be the motto of life. No. Following and imitating are not the same thing. Yes.
We cannot imitate the Lord by lifting Govardhan Hill as the Lord did in his childhood. It is impossible for any human being. We have to follow his instructions, but we may not imitate them in any way. The Srimad Bhagavatam affirms this as follows. One should simply follow the instructions of the controllers and should not imitate them in their activities. Their instructions are all good for us, and any intelligent person must perform them as instructed. However, one should guard against trying to imitate their actions. One should not try to drink the ocean of poison imitating Lord Shiva. You should always remember the position of the Ishvaras, those who can all actually control the movements of the sun and the moon. Without such power, one cannot imitate the Ishvaras or the super powerful. The example set herein is very appropriate. Lord Shiva drank poison to the extent of swallowing the ocean. But if any common man tries to drink even a fragment of such poison, he will be killed. There are many pseudo devotees of Lord Shiva who want to indulge in smoking ganja, marijuana, and similar intoxicating drugs, forgetting that by so imitating the acts of Lord Shiva, they are falling dead very near. Similarly, there are some pseudo devotees of Lord Krishna who prefer to imitate the Lord in the matter of the rock lila, or dance of love, forgetting their inability to lift the boat downhill. It is best, therefore, that one not try to imitate the powerful, but simply endeavor to follow their instructions. Nor should one try to occupy the post of the powerful without qualification. There are so many incarnations of God without the power of the Supreme Godhead. 25. As the ignorant perform their duties with attachment to results, similarly,
this morning the press representative, he was astonished that Swamiji, so many people are coming, they are declaring that I am God, what is this? So these rascals are like that. Therefore, there are so many incarnations of God without the power. So people, why they should be cheated? If somebody comes and says that I am God, why don't you taste. For tasting this, when Krishna assumed the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Pusha Arjuna was convinced. He accepted Parabrahma Paramdhama. But for future guidance, he requested Krishna, please show me your universal form. Otherwise, without showing universal, they are still claiming that I am God. So God is not so cheap thing. They are imitating, trying to imitate. This is very dangerous. And those who are accepting such rascals, they are also not intelligent. They should know. Yeah, just like I asked the president, suppose if I come and say that I am President Johnson, would you accept me? Similarly, people should know what is God? What is the definition of God? How can I accept a rascal as God? They have no sense of. Somebody comes, I am God, and he accepts. Yes, he is God. But is this not? God.
As the ignorant perform their duty with attachment to the Lord, similarly the learned may also act, but without attachment, for the sake of leading people on the right path. 26. Let not the wise disrupt the mind of the ignorant who are attached to spiritual action. They should not be encouraged to refrain from work, but to engage in work in the spirit of devotion.
Just like Haridasa Thakur. Haridasa Thakur was chanting in a secluded place always. Now, if somebody without being elevated to such high position imitates, so Haridasa Thakur chanted, let me sit down in a solitary place and chant. He cannot do that. It is not possible. He'll simply imitate and he'll do all nonsense. Therefore, everyone should be engaged in his own work. And by the fruit of his work, he should serve Krishna. We cannot imitate Haridasa Thakur. That is a different position. If one is elevated to that position, that is a different thing. But generally, that is not meant for ordinary person. Therefore, everyone should do his occupational duty and try to serve the Lord by the result of his work. That should be the motto of that.
Go on. The world is spirit soul, under the influence of the three modes of material nature, thinks himself to be the doer of activities which are in actuality carried out by nature. Support. two persons, one in Krishna consciousness and the other in material consciousness, working on the same level, may appear to be working on the same platform, but there is a wide gulf of difference in their respective positions. The person in material consciousness is convinced by false ego that he is the doer of everything. With him, there is no consideration that the mechanism of the body is produced by material nature, or that material nature is under the supervision of the supreme personality of Godhead. The materialistic person has no knowledge that ultimately he is under the control of Krishna. The person in false ego takes all credit for doing everything independently, and that is the system of his nature. He does not know that this gross and subtle body is the creation of material nature under the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And as such, his bodily and mental activity should be engaged in the service of Krishna in Krishna consciousness. He does not know that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is known as Rishikesha, or the master of all senses. But due to his long misuse of his senses, he is factually deluded by the false ego, and that is the cause of his forgetfulness of his eternal relationship with Krishna. 28. One who has knowledge of the absolute truth, Almighty Yama, does not engage himself in the senses of sense gratification. Knowing well the differences between work and devotion, and work for fruit to be done. So far. The knower of the absolute truth is convinced of his awkward position in material association. He knows that he is part and parcel of the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna, and that his position should not be in the material creation. He knows his real identity as part and parcel of the supreme, who is eternal bliss and knowledge. And he realizes that somehow or other he is now entrapped in the material conception of life. In his short state of existence, he is meant to dovetail his activity in devotional service with the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna. He therefore engages himself in the activities of Krishna consciousness and becomes naturally unattached to the activities of the material senses, which are all circumstantial and temporary. He knows that his material condition of life is under the supreme control of the Lord. Consequently, he is not disturbed by any kind of material reaction, which he considers to be the mercy of the Lord. According to the Srimad Bhagavatam, one who knows the absolute truth in three different teachings, namely Brahman, Paramatma, and the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is called Tattvani. For he knows also his own factual position in relationship with the Supreme.
There is a verse in Srimad Bhagavatam, Vadanti Tattvavidastat Satyam Yad Jnanam Adhyam. Tattvavid. Tattva means truth, and vid means one who knows. So, a person who knows all these things, he is called Tattvavid.
Bewildered by the mode of material nature, the ignorant fully engages himself in material activity and become attached, but the wise should not unsettle them, although these duties are inferior due to the performer's lack of knowledge. Support. Men who are ignorant cannot appreciate activities in Krishna consciousness. Therefore, Lord Krishna advises us not to disturb them and simply waste valuable time. But the devotees of the Lord are more kind than the Lord, because they understand the purpose of the Lord. Consequently, they undertake all kinds of risks, even to the point of approaching ignorant men to try and engage them in the acts of Krishna consciousness, which are absolutely necessary for the human being.
Yes, Krishna says that the devotees, that you should not disturb them. But devotees are so kind that taking all risks
Just like Nityananda Prabhu took all risks. Lord Jesus Christ took all risks. Therefore, a devotee is more kind than God. A devotee is more merciful than God Himself. We should always remember. And therefore, Krishna says, Mad bhaktya puja bhudika. Anyone who worships my devotee, he worships more than what he can do for me. That means he appreciates the worship of his devotee than to himself. Therefore, devotee is so, dear to Krishna. That will be explained in the 18th chapter. The person who takes all risks for preaching God consciousness, nobody is dearer than him in the human society. Krishna says that. Wow.
Therefore, O Arjuna, surrendering all your works unto me, with mind intent on me, and without desire for gain, and free from ego and lethargy, fight. Therefore, this verse clearly indicates the whole purpose of the Bhagavad Gita. The Lord instructs that one has to become fully Krishna conscious to discharge duty, as if in military discipline. Such an injunction may make things a little difficult, but that is the constitutional position of the living entity. The living entity cannot be happy independent of the cooperation of the Supreme Lord, because the eternal constitutional position of a living entity is to become subordinate to the desire of the Lord. Arjuna was therefore ordered by Sri Krishna to fight as if the Lord were his military commander. One has to sacrifice everything for the goodwill of the Supreme Lord, and at the same time discharge his prescribed duty without claim to proprietorship. Arjuna did not have to consider the order of the Lord. He had only to execute his order. The Supreme Lord is the soul of all souls. Therefore, one who depends solely and wholly on the Supreme Soul, without personal consideration, or in other words, one who is fully Krishna conscious, is called
Adhyatma. Adhyatma.
One has to act in the order of a master. One should not expect any truthful result. The cashier may count millions of dollars in his employer, but he does not claim a cent out of the great amount of money. Similarly, one has to take it for granted that nothing in the world belongs to any individual person, but everything belongs to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the real purport of Krishna saying, unto me. And when one acts in such Krishna consciousness, certainly he does not claim proprietorship over anything. So this consciousness is, quote, mere mama, or nothing is mine. And if there is any reluctance to execute such a stern order, which is without consideration of so-called kinsmen in the bodily relationship, that reluctance should be thrown off. In this way, one may become without feverish mentality or lethargy. Everyone, according to his quality and position, has a particular type of work to discharge, and all such duties may be discharged in Krishna consciousness as described above. That will lead one to the path of liberation.
Thank you. Now, if anybody has any question?
In the past, when the Lord didn't practice yoga, concentration on Krishna was in the heart. When they accepted this, were they rendering devotional service?
Yes. Devotional service, there are nine kinds of. Sravanam, kirtanam, vishnu smaranam, padasevanam, Archanam Bandhanam Dasam Sakham Matmanivedanam. So, Sarvanam, just you are very kindly hearing. This is also the personal service. Those who are patiently hearing these topics of Krishna consciousness, they are also discharging devotional service. Hearing. Savanam, Kirtanam. And just you are reading, you are also service, rendering service. Similarly, those who are always thinking of Krishna, he is also rendering service. Samanam, Kirtanam, Vishnas, Maranam, Pada, Sevanam. Those who are engaged in the service of this temple, they are discharging devotional service, Pada, Sevanam. Archanam. Those who are engaged in the service of the deity, they are executing devotional service. Bandhanam. Those who are offering prayer, they are engaged in devotional service. Just like in Christian church or mosque, they have no deity, but they offer prayer. That is devotional service. So, everyone in relationship with God, there are so many formulas. If he follows all the formulas, or some of them, or at least one of them, sincerely, then you will get perfection. That is the way. Savanam kirtanam visnas maranam padu sivanam achyanam bandhanam dasam sakkhamasam vedanam. But for all devotional service, the main pillar is sarvanam, hearing. Without hearing, other process of devotional service will not be perfect. Therefore, hearing is most important. Hearing, according to our Vaishnava philosophy, especially Lord Chaitanya's, hearing and chanting are two main pillars for devotional service. Drink water. So, those who are concentrating mind, thinking of Krishna, that is the perfection of yoga system. But they have no idea of Krishna. They make some circle, they concentrate. That is a practice only. So how to engage one's mind? Because mind is so flickering. I am thinking of a red circle, and then next moment I think something red. And from that red, I go to something red, mind is gone. Okay? So this concentration of mind is very difficult in these days, because mind is so agitated. Therefore, force them to hear Hare Krishna. Even they have no mind to hear, you chant loudly Hare Krishna, they will hear. Their mind will be dragged. It is so nice. He hasn't got to concentrate. I will force him. You see? So as soon as he hears Krishna, he advances. He gets one. So this is the nicest and the great service to the humanity. Chant Hare Krishna. And they will be profited. You see? Yes.
Oh.
Yes, they will die because they are imitating. The result will be death. That's all. Yes. NBS? Everyone is envious. This world is envious. They declare the God is dead. There is a proverb in Bengali that one person wanted to see how many thieves are there in this village. And when he began to scrutinize, he saw that everyone is a thief. Similarly, envious. To begin from President Johnson and go to anyone, they are all envious of God consciousness. You see? Otherwise, in Los Angeles City, there are millions and trillions of people, and only a dozen people are coming here. You see? Why? They are envious. What is this nonsense, God consciousness, Krishna consciousness? You see? So we have to disturb them. That is our duty. We have to disturb this envious person. Hare Krishna! That is our duty, to disturb them. And that is the greatest service. Just like a man is sleeping, when somebody is coming to kill him, another friend, Mr. Such and Such, wake up, wake up, wake up. So he may say, why you are disturbing? But that is the greatest service. He will say, Maya is coming to kill him, to send him to the darkest region of hell, and you are saving him. Chant Hare Krishna, and be saved. These people, they do not know how much they are under the trap of Maya, illusion. They are thinking that they are very happy, they are making progress. But they do not know actually the position. This is called illusion. Any other question? Yes. Yes. Before coming to Krishna consciousness, were you in the Varnasram? Then how you have come? How you have come to this position? No. You have come to execute Krishna consciousness. Before coming to this Krishna consciousness, were you in Varnasram Dharma? No. So, at the present moment, there is no possibility of persons following the principles of Varnasram Dharma, either here or anywhere. Everyone is Varnasram Kala. Kalau Shuddha Sambhava. In this age, everyone is a Shudra. Nobody is Brahmin, nobody is Kshatriya, nobody is Vaishya. Shudra. So, in this age, you won't find anybody following the Varnasram Dharma. Therefore, this is the panacea.
to engage everyone in Krishna consciousness, chanting Hare Krishna. He comes above the highest principle of Brahmanism. This is the greatest gift to the humanity, that even he is in the, fallen condition, and the most degraded position, he can be raised to the highest position simply by chanting.